हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट एंकल जॉइंट हिस्ट्री क्वेश्चंस। सो माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर स्नेहा भाटिया, एमपीटी इन ऑर्थोपेडिक्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स रिहैबिलिटेशन, इंचार्ज प्रिंसिपल एट लीड श्रीमती एस जी पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी। सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट विथ माई लेक्चर, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट द ऑडियंस हु हैव येट नॉट सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल, सो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड 20% ऑफ द सब्सक्राइबर्स हैव नॉट प्रेस द बेल आइकन येट, सो प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू गेट नोटिफाइड फॉर द नेक्स्ट वीडियो। सो इन हिस्ट्री टेकिंग, वेन वी आर टेकिंग हिस्ट्री फ्रॉम अ पेशेंट हु इज़ हैविंग एंकल जॉइंट इंजुरी, दीज आर द क्वेश्चन that we must ask the patient. So first of all, we should ask the patient what is the patient's occupation, whether the patient stands for a longer period of time, what type of surfaces patient is actually standing for a great period of time, and what is the factor causing the problem. So we have to ask the history, occupational history of the patient, and then we can come to know whether prolonged standing posture can cause the pain. Then we have to ask the patient what was the mechanism of injury. So if the patient is having any history of trauma, then we have to find out the mechanism of injury for the patient. What was the position of the foot at the time of the injury? So if the patient can remember, we have to identify what was the position of the ankle joint when the patient met with an injury, and that can tell us which anatomical structure must have got injured. So ankle sprains occur most often when the foot is plantar flexed, inverted and adducted with injury to the anterior talofibular ligament, that is ATFL, anterolateral capsule and possibly the distal tibiofibular ligament. Did the patient notice a transient or fixed deformity of the foot or ankle at the time of the injury? So if the patient has seen any injury, deformity can also indicate a possibility of a fracture. So we have to ask the patient that when the patient had the trauma, met with the trauma or had any injury that time, whether there was any visible deformity or not. Was the patient able to continue the activity after the injury? If so, the injury is probably not too severe, provided there is no loss of stability. Inability to weight bear, severe pain and rapid swelling indicates a severe injury. So we have to ask the patient that after he met with the injury, whether the patient was able to stand or he was able to weight bear on the same side leg. If he could continue with the activity, that means the injury is not that severe. But if the patient complains that he was not at all able to weight bear on the same leg and was not able to walk or not a severe pain was there, then that indicates the severity of the injury. Was there any swelling or bruising, ecchymosis was there? How quickly and where did it develop? So if the patient has developed any kind of swelling on the ankle joint, so we have to ask the patient that whether the swelling was huge or not, and how many hours it has taken for that swelling to evolve. Idea of the type of the swelling, so whether it is a blood swelling, synovial swelling or purulent swelling. So if we ask the patient that what was the swelling was immediately after the injury or it was after some time, and whether the swelling developed quickly or the swelling developed later in the history, then that can give us the idea what kind of swelling it can be, whether it is intracapsular swelling or extracapsular swelling. So we can come to know whether it is intracapsular or extracapsular swelling by asking the patient about all these questions. Are the symptoms improving, becoming worse or staying the same? So this can tell us whether the condition of the patient is acute, subacute or chronic condition. So if the patient is having chronic condition, then he may complain that the pain or disability that he is having is from the long time and there is no improvement in the state of disability. What are the sites and boundaries of pain or abnormal sensation? Pattern is one of a dermatome, a peripheral nerve or another painful structure. So we have to ask the patient, if patient is having any pain or swelling, then we have to ask that the pain is in particular region of the dermatome or not, because if the pain is because of the pain is in any dermatomal region, then that can indicate that particular dermatome is involved. But if the pain is due to nerve origin, then along the course of the nerve, the patient may have pain. So that is why we have to ask the patient about the sites and the boundaries of the pain or abnormal sensation. What is the patient's usual activity or pastime? So stress is placed on the lower leg, ankle and foot. That we can come to know if we ask the patient what is his usual activity. So if the patient is engaged in some kind of sports or he is going for jogging and running, whether he is able to continue those activity or he is not able to continue those kind of activity, that will tell us the amount of stress that is on the ankle joint. Does activity make a difference? Pain after the activity suggests overuse. For example, with overuse injuries, pain initially comes on after the activity, and later stages of the problem, the pain is constantly present. So we have to ask the patient that when the patient is performing certain activities, after that the pain is increasing or decreasing, or the pain is continuously, constantly present. So all this thing can tell us the severity of the condition. In mild condition, even after doing certain activity, patient won't feel more pain. But in case of severe condition, maybe patient won't be able to perform certain activities. So where is the pain? We have to ask the patient about the location of the pain. Does the patient indicate a specific location or area? For example, with shin splints or a compartment syndrome, the patient usually indicates a diffuse area. Peroneal tendon problem show posterior lateral pain and may be associated with lateral ankle instability. So the location of the pain can give us the proper, with the location of the pain, we can come to a proper diagnosis. So very important that we ask the patient where is the location of his pain. Does walking on various terrains make a difference in regard to the foot problem? If so, which terrains cause the most obvious problem? So if the patient is performing activity on different kind of surfaces, then we have to ask that performing activities on one particular type of surface, whether that increases the patient's pain or not. What type of shoes does the patient wear? What kind of heel do the shoe have? Are the shoes in good condition? Does the patient make use of orthosis? The examiner should also note whether the shoes offer proper support or not. So we have footwear. Footwear plays important role. Sometimes what happens, if we see in sports people who are engaged in athletic activities, their shoes are not proper, then that can also give rise to ankle sprains. So we have to ask the patient what type of shoe he is wearing, whether that shoe is specific for that particular sport or not, and whether the shoe has been modified according to the condition of the patient. Because if the patient is having some deformity, then alternative arrangement for the shoes also should be done. Shoe modification should have been done. But if that is not proper, then that can also give rise to increase in the number of ankle injuries. Is there any history of previous injury? For example, poliomyelitis may lead to a pace cavus. Systematic conditions such as diabetes, gout, psoriasis and collagen diseases may manifest first in the foot. So we have to ask the patient whether the patient has any condition, pre-existing condition, which can affect the ankle joint. For example, diabetes, some symptoms of the diabetes is primarily first seen in case of the ankle joint. Gout also, if we see in gout, the swelling and the swollen joints can be seen first in the ankle joint as well as the PIP and DIP joint of the foot. Psoriasis also we can see first if it can be notified by seeing the lower leg and the ankle. So some conditions can be identified by observing the ankle joint. So we have to ask the patient whether he has any history of previous injury or any previous medical condition. For active people, especially the runners or joggers, the following question should also be considered. Duration of running and jogging. So we have to ask the patient for how many minutes or how many hours they are engaged in particular activity, activities like running and jogging, what type of surface they are running on, and what type of workout they are performing. Sometimes patient may also complain that they were going to the gym, but because of the ankle injury, they are not able to continue with the gym anymore. So in that case, we have to ask them what kind of specific exercises they were performing, what kind of workout regimes they were following at the gym. Types of warm-up stretching exercises, so whether if they were engaged in any sports or any gym activities, so whether they were performing any warm-up activities or they were doing any stretching exercises before the session, before the start of the exercise. So we have to ask this, because if they were not performing proper warm-up and stretching techniques, then the chances are more that they may have ankle ligament tears. Shoe type, whether they were wearing proper shoes or not. When was the patient's last race and how long was it? So if the patient was engaged in any kind of running activity, so after the injury, whether the patient was able to run or not. And if he ran his last race, then for how much duration, how many minutes or how many hours he could sustain that activity. So all these questions will help us to come to a accurate diagnosis. So reference for the today's video, I have taken the content from the book Orthopedic Physical Assessment, David Maggie. So coronavirus can heal, but the stigma won't. So we have to be kind to each other. If somebody around us has been diagnosed with the coronavirus disease, then don't create a social stigma. Be kind to them and support the people who are working to fight against the corona. Thank you for watching this video. If you have enjoyed watching this video, then please subscribe my channel, share it with your friends, and press the bell icon to get notified for the next video. Thank you.